We welcome you into week one of the Ken Sparks Show. Hello, I'm Adam Cavalier, the voice of the Eagles, alongside Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. A tough home opener for Carson-Newman's Eagles. CN falls to Humboldt State out of Arcata, California, 52-45 in a clash between top 15 teams. Ken, a frustrating affair, a blocked punt, 18 penalties for 145 yards. Both of those are program highs since the year 2000. How do you sum up your week one contest?
Well, I sum up as an opportunity to grow and learn, or as an opportunity to really disintegrate and go downhill. So it's just a matter of how we want to handle it and how we respond to it. As far as game, there was times when we were a good football team, and there was times when we weren't a very good football team. And you know, anytime you have 18 penalties and a blocked punt, you're probably going to get beat. Mm-hmm. You know, 80% of the time that a team has a blocked punt, they lose. And that's we just had a major breakdown on that, and by a few individuals or one individual in particular, and then so we got beat in the penalty game. We got beat in the kicking game because mm-hmm. we missed a field goal. We got beat in the punting average field mm-hmm. position wise. We got beat in the kickoff return field position average wise. So we lost in the kicking game, and and we lost in some major times when we needed to make something happen when we didn't. We just needed to make a play, and we didn't make mm-hmm. a play. So, but when you get almost 700 yards offense, you're supposed to win.
Yeah,
and we didn't. That's two times that's happened to us, and. We were playing several freshmen on defense and a couple on offense, and it showed up. And so we just got to keep working at it and get better.
You mentioned the special teams. What was it about the kickoff return offense struggling to get 20-yard returns? And then defensively, you gave up a handful of long ones, but nothing too glaring. But field position definitely wasn't on your side.
No, it wasn't. And in a game like this, we're a possession or 10 yards on the field will make a major difference. We lost that battle. Mm-hmm. And our kickoff return was terrible. And kickoff, just the fact that he kicked four of them in the end zone and he didn't get a chance to return them helped us a lot. Mm-hmm. But this guy continued to improve in those areas.
We'll take a look at the first half when we return after this on the Ken Sparks Show. Back on the Ken Sparks Show as Carson-Newman falls to Humboldt State 52-45 to open up the year, snapping a 6-year winning streak on opening day for Carson-Newman's Eagles. Ken, you haven't lost on opening day in some time. What challenges and, I don't want to call them advantages, but where's the ray of sunshine in an opening day loss? Because let's face it, last time you had an opening day loss, you went to the semifinals.
Well, that's hope. And excuse me, but we had a lot of bright spots. We really did. We feel like we can eliminate some mistakes and be a really good football team before this thing's over with. And that's the key, you know, is to always be doing this. And so we're going to get better. We'll be a good football team before the year's over.
How much credit goes to Humboldt State in this? What did they do that was problematic for you?
Well, offensively, they had all their starters back. They had a 2-year starter back at quarterback. And they're very balanced where they can mm-hmm. run and throw, and had skilled people at both places. They were a very good challenge offensively. For us defensively, and I think they'll probably be as good offensively as anybody will play all year. Will they be the best team we play all year? No. We'll play better football teams mm-hmm. than them. But it's just, but they were well prepared, well coached. They didn't I don't think we got any turnovers from them. They didn't get any from us, and we needed some turnovers. We needed some short fields, and we needed some three and outs, and we didn't get that.
Game starts with a bang. First play from scrimmage, Antonio Wimbush, 80 yards to the house. What were your thoughts after the opening play?
Well, I didn't think about it much, to be honest with you, because one play don't make a game. And sometimes that might work for you, and sometimes that may work against you because of the way kids think, you know. And so so it ended up not being all that it could have been, I guess. We needed a second play and a third play like that. So then it would have been something to talk about.
Well, first half you did have the modus operandi was the big play. Four touchdowns, all of them for longer than 20 yards, three of them for longer than 65 yards.
I know.
What happened on the screen, the draw, what happened on those big plays?
Well, we had 11 people doing the job, getting it done. And they were good calls and well executed. And when that happens, you know, good things come out of it.
Humboldt State had the lead at the half, 31-28. We take a look at the first half highlights.
Super under center, looks left and right, now takes the snap. It's a trap right for Wimbush. Wimbush straight ahead to the 40, cuts left with a blocker to midfield. Wimbush down the left sideline, 30, 20, can he beat a man to the end zone? See you later, touchdown, Carson Newman! One play! 80 yards, and the Eagles are on board first. But Carson-Newman does retain a 7-3 lead with 9.5 minutes to go first quarter. King has his punt blocked. It is picked up in stride by the Lumberjacks, and the Jacks, Tex Keith, will score. Taylor and Jones, the running back, super back to pass. Airing it out down the left sideline, looking for Snead. Snead in stride at the 30. And he is unable to stay in bounds. He steps out down at the 29. If he's able to keep his balance and stay in, it's a touchdown, no doubt. But the Eagles go over the top to the fastest man in college football. And Snead delivers to get him inside the Humboldt State 30. 10-7 lead with under 2 to go in the first quarter. Trips to the wide side right, low man short side left. Hand off Gardner. Gardner straight ahead. Gardner bursts into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacks. 17-7 lead for Humboldt State. Second and 15 for the Eagles. It's a draw for Jamal Jones. Jamal Jones steps out of a tackle at the 42. Racing along the left hash marks. Jones high steps his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Carson Newman. Jamal Jones leaves Castro in his wake as he bounces 68 yards for the score. And the Eagles are within 4. In the shotgun, Burmeister in motion to the short side left. Snap back, pass, Weber looks deep to Burmeister along the left sideline, got it in stride, wide open, snares it, touchdown Lumberjacks. Wide set, one to the short side right, two to the wide side left. Super under center, he takes, runs the option left, and Humboldt State covered it up well, but Super bounces through a hole out to the right sideline. Super along the right sideline, across the 45, down inside the 40, where he's shoved out by Owens. I've Carson Newman from the Lumberjack 22. Super under center takes. Runs pitch to the right for Wimbush. Wimbush cuts the corner at the 20. Racing along the right sideline. He dashes 4-6. Touchdown, Carson Newman. Wimbush, touchdown number 2 of the day. And his third career 100-yard rushing performance with that carry. A 22-yard score. And Carson Newman is back within 4. Man in motion, Gardner out to the left. Hand off to Doctor right side. Doctor buckled down at the kneecaps by Jason Williams up at the 27-yard line. Just a yard gain again. And now Humboldt State in danger of going three and out for the first time today. And that would be big for the Eagles. Down 3 here at the end of the first half. Super takes. Blitz comes from the left. Super pressure. Rolls it out. There's the screen. Complete to Jones. Jones shakes and bakes a man at the 35. Jones with blocking along the right sideline. Jukes another man at the 35. Jones with the wheels. Houses one on the screen. Touchdown, Carson Newman. Mr. Karnak, Michael Watrang calls up the screen, and the Eagles deliver from 70 yards away.
Those are the first half highlights. Eagles trailed 31-28 at the halftime break. Ken, what was your message to the team when you were in the locker room?
Well, the same as always. Play every play like you're supposed to play it. Play believing that things are going to happen. It was one of them games where we never could hardly get over the hump. You know, a penalty or a execution or a missed block or a missed tackle would keep us from, you know, I think we played from behind most of the ball game.
Yeah.
And that's not a very positive way when you got a young football team in places. It's not a very good positive way to get it done.
At times, your hand was forced. You had four freshman defensive backs.
That's right.
Out there. How did that affect things?
Well, some big mistakes, and you saw some big plays because of it, but some really hope for their future and for our future through them because we had some guys that really did some things special. We got some athletes back there.
Yeah.
It's going to get better.
Antonio Wimbush, Jamal Jones, each rush for career highs, both find the end zone multiple times. What about the job that your running backs and Montavious Taylor, who was a yard shy of 100.
What, 99 yards?
Yeah.
And then I think Noah had over 100, and then he had...
Gross, yeah, but his net was right. 86 or so.
Right. Well, our total rushing was 400-something yards, and so 460-something, I think, and our total offense was almost 700 yards. Come on. You know, come on, you're supposed to, you know... And no turnovers. You're supposed to win that ball game.
What is the room for improvement there for a Noah Suber and Antonio Wimbush for that group who did, at least numbers wise, put some stuff up?
Well, Noah, first of all, we can protect him a whole lot better, so we don't have to start scrambling right off the bat. The second thing, of course, he was his own worst enemy a couple of times on that. By not sprinting all the way out or not getting a quick enough drop. And missing a few reads on the option. All those things, you know, it was first ball game. He's going to get better. First ball game he started, you know. But what an unbelievable, great first ball game. If you build on that one, you got something. And running backs not taking the right angles to block. And not getting the blocking thing done like they need to, and then a few times missing the veer lane. But overall, I mean, come on, 700 yards. You gotta say somebody did something right.
Yeah.
You know, you can't be too nitpicky on that one.
Yeah.
But we'll get a lot better than that. I promise you, we will.
Take a look at the second half when we return after this on the Ken Sparks Show. Back on the Ken Sparks Show as Carson-Newman falls to Humboldt State in the opener, 52-45. I'm Adam Cavalier alongside Carson-Newman head football coach Ken Sparks. Ken, a second half that was really a seesaw battle. You tie the game at 31 and a tie from every point then on out. But Humboldt State, for all intents and purposes, just like Valdosta State in the playoffs, scored last.
Got the ball last, didn't it? We had a chance. When the score was tied and we had the ball, which, you know, when every time we got the ball, we knew we just needed to score. We had a bad third down decision. Kind of went for the home run on third down when we should have got the first down. Mm-hmm. We should have been going for the first down. And then another decision, and I was kind of gutless on that, was I started to fake the punt with 3 minutes left. And they were giving us what we needed to fake the punt, you know, and I probably should have done it. And even alerted the team going out there, and they lined up the way we wanted them to. But we'd had a breakdown or two with the punt team, and I wasn't sure that I could count on them to execute the fake punt. And so I bellied up on it. And in hindsight, I should have done that. We should have gone for it. And next time, I'll holler at you, and you'll say, "Come on, come on, gutless, let's go. Get your backbone." What it was, it about 38 seconds left, I think, when they scored, and then we just didn't have enough time, especially with our kickoff return game. Good gracious, that we could we could throw it up and hope, and that's what we ended up doing. Mm-hmm. And that's not a good offense.
No.
Throw it up and hope.
No.
You know, but I might work in the backyard sometimes, but that don't happen too good in a college game. So we were, that was probably when the biggest disappointment came over me.
We take a look at the second half highlights as Carson-Newman falls to Humboldt State 52-45.
31-all with 3:03 left in the third quarter. Gardner behind Weber in the pistol. Two wide receivers each direction, ball between the hash marks. Now Gardner in motion out to the wide side right. Low snap to Weber, looking left the whole way. Throws left, has a man, Crevichet. Crevichet in stride at the five. Will beat Bloom to the pylon. Touchdown, Jacks. Here's second and eight for the Eagles from their own 32. Suber takes option keeper right. Suber bounces it out to the 40. Pitches late to Taylor. He stays in bounds across the 45 of Humboldt State and down to the 40-yard line. A big play and a late pitch for Noah Suber. Pitching the ball 20 yards downfield. Charles knocks him out, but it's still good enough for a 28-yard gain. First and 10, Carson-Newman from the right hash at Humboldt State 20. Suber takes trap for Taylor, for Jones up the middle. Jones steps out of a tackle at the 10, scoots right, and heads for six. Touchdown, Carson-Newman! The go-ahead score here. Pistol look for Weber. Takes the snap. Hands to Gardner. Untouched. Over the right side of the line, he's in. Touchdown, Jacks. 44-38, Lumbert for Humboldt State. Suber moving quickly. He takes, fumbles it, grabs it back, ekes his way forward, and somehow comes out of the horde of bodies and scores! What on earth? Where did that come from? Touchdown, Carson-Newman! Suber was into the jaws of the beast and emerged unscathed and scampers 23 yards for a touchdown. Holy free, holy! Seavers go to the wide side left. Low man short side right. Gardner behind Weber in the pistol. Snap back. Hand off Gardner straight ahead. First through a hole to the 30. To the 20. Gardner racing down the right sideline and Gardner gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacks. A 39-yard run for the Harlan Hill Trophy candidate, and he comes through in the clutch when the Jacks needed him most.
Those are the second half highlights as Carson-Newman falls to Humboldt State 52-45. Coming up next, we'll shine our Eagle spotlight on Carson-Newman's senior class. That's when the Ken Spark Show returns right after this. Back on the Ken Sparks Show, time now for our Eagle Spotlight, and this time Michael Watrang puts it on Carson-Newman's senior leadership.
Carson-Newman's 2016 roster features 16 seniors. The defense is filled with young talent, while the offense is looking to replace seven starters from a year ago. For first-team All-Conference offensive lineman Austin Lewis, there may be new players on his side of the ball, but not inexperienced.
What's crazy is Noah came in with me my freshman year, so I've known Noah for the last 4 years now, and I've always said that once this kid gets a shot, he's going to be good. He's going to be great, honestly. He's got a cannon on him. I mean, he's come in, and he's taken all the second-string snaps when Dre was here, and, I mean, some of those other guys have rotated in and played games, so it's not like they're new or, like you said, they're veterans, but, I mean, some of them had game experience.
The intrigue on the defensive side of the football stems from a new defensive coordinator. Larry Slade will lead a unit that expects to start five underclassmen. Senior All-Conference corner Jason Williams has been an emotional leader since arriving on campus and is looking forward to the challenge.
You know, in the secondary, we're pretty young. Me and Jerry are the older guys, and, you know, we're going to have two freshmen starting in the, you know, one freshman starting as a corner and one freshman starting as a safety. And just for me personally, as far as, you know, greater than just a verbal leader, you know, just being an example of, you know, what our expectations are and what we got going on here and just how to do things.
One player on the roster that's appreciative of an opportunity to play is first-team All-Conference offensive lineman Dan Gallman. He tore his ACL in the spring and received an eye-opening lesson of how important going through the intricacies of football is to him.
When you're like me and you've been playing for so long, you've been playing in all these games, it just kind of molds together and you don't really think about it. And then when that injury happened, it was just like, oh, my football career might be over. And luckily with Dr. Rapay and the training staff, I'm able to come back. And it really, like, during that whole time out, I was like looking at Austin lead the guys and all those guys run, and I was just like, man, I want to be out there so bad. Like, it made you realize how much you love football. And so coming back into it, it's like I really get to embrace those this last year and those last plays, because you never know when you might tear your ACL again at any play.
It would be easy to look at the season as a whole for any senior, but Lewis understands that each second can be crucial to the team's success.
It's kind of one of those things is you got to take it play by play, I mean practice by practice, day by day. It's just got to don't really look towards the future, because then you'll miss it. All the like little experiences that you have in practice where Coach Turner will say something funny about one of the newer guys, or we score on a 32, which is just a dive up the middle. I mean, it's just one of those things that you'll miss if you just kind of look towards the future and expect to go to the playoffs. You just got to take it every step of the way.
While play on the football field will be etched in the record books, Gallman believes the 2016 senior class will be defined by what they do off the turf.
To make a difference, whether it be on the field with our teammates, or whether it be for the fans, or whether it be for our community. I feel like those teams that stand out the most are those championship teams, but it's also those teams that had a great impact on the community, whether it be people from Jefferson City, the student body, faculty, just guys that make others people's days better by being around them.
Williams summed up the feeling of all of the seniors by saying that it hasn't hit him yet. Knowing that there is 11 guaranteed football games on the schedule this year, the cornerback emphasized that this team will take advantage of every opportunity they get to cement their legacy. For the Ken Sparks Show, I'm Michael Watrang.
Thank you very much, Michael Watrang. Ken Sparks, Eagle Spotlight Senior Leadership. It feels like yet again you've got another good core group of guys to lead this team.
Yeah, I think we do. I think we're blessed to have some kids that's been in the program and understand what we're about, and to see them buy in and grow and develop as young men is always exciting. And we're not talking about just with the football team. We're talking about, you know, in the community and in their families, you know, in their future, and that's what it's all about. And that's what football is supposed to do for you.
Ken Sparks, pleasure as always. Thanks for letting me be on your show.
it's your show now.
That is false and erroneous. It's false and erroneous. Ken, thanks for the time.
Thanks, buddy.
That is Carson Newman, head football coach Ken Sparks, on the voice of the Eagles, Adam Cavalier. This has been the Ken Sparks Show. Join us Saturday, September 10th, on the Eagles Sports Network when the Eagles take on St. Augustine's at 1:00. Thanks for watching.